Hey traders, happy Sunday to you. Random Sunday. I don't even know why I'm here. I was up till like 5 something in the morning because of tornadoes. Like, holy crap, tornado came so close to my neighborhood. Like, it was touchdown too. So I'm here and I'm okay. All right, just letting people know. But Bitcoin seems to be okay, right? We were about $20 off. No, we were like $13 off the measured move of the slanted head and shoulders before bullishly engulfing and breaking the upside. Unfortunately, I mean, this is great and all, but you know what this pattern is developing, right? I mean, this is... Do we really need to talk about it? I mean, let's go the 4 hour if you want. Yeah, it's really just, Oh, wow, I guess not. I guess it's not as... Okay, so on the 60-minute... All right, let's go back to the 60-minute, because there's no crazy wick like that, rejection wick. Okay, let me just clean this up. Because I was thinking, it just looks like a rising wedge, just to the naked eye. Well, at least on the 60-minute, all right? So, it's just like this, you know? You got the upsloping resistance, right? But then you got, like, now two touch points here, and it just looks like a huge, perfect rising wedge, right? I mean, am I crazy here? Have I lost my freaking mind? Anyone else see that? After the huge move down, you're now upsloping and now consolidating, right? So, rising wedge. I don't know. Maybe I'm still sleeping or something. Okay. Anyone have an idea or an opinion on this? Because I see it. Excuse me. Wow. Okay. I'm just saying, dude. So, that's not really good. That's not really what you're looking for. That means we could run up to like 5170 or something. See how we do against, you know, look, we last on the 60 minute, we used that 200 moving average as resistance twice. So let's see what happens. Third time's a charm, 5150. So, not that great. Not that great, man. What's up, Dalal? Tic Tac coming from the Netherlands, man. Welcome. What's up, Eric? Dude, thanks for the follow on DLive. If you're not on DLive, know that PewDiePie is live today. We must be on our best behavior, or we must be at least, whatever, a little bit more active. You love the early stream, Rick Schmitz, man? Eh, I kind of like it. It's okay. It's not bad. Hold on. All right. Sorry. Again, I just, not as much sleep as I would have wanted, but it happens, man. It's already 9 o'clock at night for you, Mr. Drent guy. Drent. Dr. Ernt guy. Oh, yeah. Tiger's going to rally back, man. Or Bitcoin's going to rally because Tiger's back. Yeah, dude. How much back is he, though? Do we really know? All right, man. So it's going to be real tough hitting 618. How are you going to hit 5264 when you're developing upsloping consolidation after an impulse down? All right. That's not good. It's not what we're looking for. Not the pattern. Good God, man. I just haven't given myself enough time. Okay. It's like, first thing to do. Well, stream. Okay. All right, man. That's Bitcoin, dude. Developing potentially a 60-minute rising wedge. Okay. And just like take a look at Ethereum. Ethereum is now breaking the upside, and I had it a certain way. We could just adjust. I think it was like, remember we had the flag? Let me show you how we had it initially. And it seems like we just kept going sideways. So that kind of invalidated that this is the way it was initially. And I think this is, we hit the bottom of it. Yeah, it was perfect, man. All right. You got yourself just that bear pole, bear flag. Bear pole, bear flag combination. First target hit of the huge bear's crab pattern. All right, now we're waiting for another move to the downside. Remember, Bitcoin can go up to 5,200, 5,160 or something like that before hitting the top of its consolidation pattern, it seems like now, okay? So, second target's 152, third target's 139, all right? So look, think about it. If Bitcoin runs the upside, what do you think Ethereum could do? Ethereum can run to the upside too. It's got plenty of room to run. It could run all the way to 171 if it wanted to before selling off again, right? So plenty of room to run inside the consolidation of the bear flag. Okay. It's only the daily or something? No, maybe the 60 minute. No, what? Hold on. Okay, that's what, the hypothetical we were looking for. I don't think we've, well, yes. It's playing out, baby. Let's get a little positive momentum, all right? And then we sell off again, and then we would get the negative momentum and the divergence needed, all right, to potentially be more comfortable with a break to the upside, right around the 200 moving average or something around our second target. I'll just move this over a little bit. Yeah, a little bit. There we go. That's it. Perfect. Gold jacket, green jacket. Who gives an S? Hey, man, a lot of people do, actually. A lot of people. Hey, man, got to respect. You definitely got to respect their tradition, their upbringing, their schemata. Just like, you know, you may have been born into something because of your parents culturally, right? Like, I was born into Alabama football, college football. It's not my fault. Hearts and minds, though. Very young age. And it was my dream, man, to always run out of the tunnel. Bryant Denny, man. Made that happen, dude. Okay. So, hey, someone is a kid and they go to the Masters for the first time and they fall in love with it. And it's their dreams playing the Masters and they play in the Masters. Man, can't get mad at them, dude, for wanting a green jacket. All right. Okay. Oh yeah, my bad, Hansy, my bad. It's still, again, I told you, I did not get much sleep last night, and I'm streaming extremely early. Okay, so that's all we can do, man. Oh hey, Gordy Pow, PewDiePie. You had to quit for the TA, Chaylin, man. You had to quit for the Verge Connect in the jar. Kappa, just kidding. What's up, CWG? Oh, what's up, chat? How y'all doing? All right, this is everything is going as we had foreseen it. All right, fill in the hypotheticals for us so we can be Kangs. Critical thinking, man. Okay. Wow. Whoa, dude. What's up, introverts united? Yeah, BNB Connect bouncing off. Hey, what did it back test? Somebody tell me true. Somebody. Oh, wait. I already think I know what we bounced off of. A critical support back from June, July. Okay. The 100% retrace. A generation recon. Cranking. Is that what cranking is? What is cranking, dude? Oh, yeah. Pundi X. S Cook. Pundi X, man. Give me your chat. I'm going there and start screaming random S coins, too. What's up, Gunnar Thompson? Oh my god. What's up, Edward, dude? Thanks for the super chat. Holy crap. I'm rich! Oh my god, man. Oh man. Not even about that, dude. Am I watching Game of Thrones today? Did Grizzly Adams have a beard? Grizzly Adams did have a beard. Pineapple. Okay. Okay. Good XRP. It did have to do it, man. It had to, and it did. If it did it, we were going to $21, man. That was just going to be a thing. It's going to happen, dude. Dude, oh my god. We getting stream sniped here with our hypotheticals? Holy crap. Dude, I'm not touching this, okay? Remember, we're like, we'll just get some positive momentum here, and then after the positive momentum subsides, start losing it, then we start getting that negative momentum on some slightly lower lows near our entry, and then we become Kangs on our entry at the bullish divergence. Come on! It is difficult to not get extremely excited, okay? Crazy, man. Eva Blackbook, man. Who cares? We trade it. Still make money on the trades. We don't care if it's a scam. It's an asset that has candles. And those candles give us coinciding variables that help us make decisions on taking entry or not. Sub Seeing 18. Thanks for the sub, dude. We appreciate that. The Twitch Prime sub, Kings. Go on your shopping spree, okay, for me, man. Wow. Holy crap. What a world we live in. Anyway, so again, what the whole hypothetical was before any of this developed was even down here, we said maybe we'll run up the 20 moving average when it was up here. We did that. We wicked off bearishly engulfed. Now we're going sideways. We just can't break above this 20 moving average, 200 moving average. And so if we sell off here, it'd be perfect, dude. It'd be perfect. Start losing that positive momentum. And then we look for the divergence at the 786, which is right around 31.45 cents. All right. Wow, dude. Over the rainbow. Over the moon. Okay. We're waiting. We're waiting for you, XRP. Make us kings, man. Make us kings. Cultural indicator. Yeah, that's the only reason why I joined this, because like PewDiePie got behind it, and like I mean, that's if you can start from the on the ground floor. Like, think about starting on Twitch as a streamer or a content creator, like from the ground floor, like at the beginning, and all you have to do is just implement it into your restream. You just act like it does. I mean, you obviously engage with chat and all that stuff. It's another level. Another variable that you have to monitor and take care of, but it's definitely worth it. Okay, so closer three or closure. Thanks for the follow on Twitch, Kangs. Welcome. Okay, so anyway, we'll wait for the entry. We'll wait for the bullish divergence to develop. We'll wait for the positive momentum to subside. That'll be it, man. Okay. Oh yeah. BNB connect. Pivoting. What was it? My chart, man. Was it always this one? Yeah. Hey. Yeah, baby. Yeah. What are we talking about? The double bottom? The tweezer double bottom rejection? Dude, come on. At critical support back from June of 2018, you had to hold, and you did with the beautiful pattern, the bullish engulfing candle. Right in the upside. All right, man, you have saved yourself for now, but still right at the previous candle high close daily, April 3rd, April 2nd. All right, you got to break that. But if you can, remember the target has been $21.13.85. And that's what we said. We were saying, man, if this is all you could muster as a bear, there's just so much buying pressure. And that's what the price at these wicks indicate, that that rejection, man, to lower prices. Crazy, man. What is XHV? That's actually a crypto. I've never even seen it before in my life. Oh my God. Eli, I'll look at it. Yeah, right after this. Okay, man. Thanks to Super Chat, dude. Okay, man. What's up, Jangalese?
Can you please chart out DTA/BTC Bitrex hashtag? Can you please chart out DTA/BTC Bitrex hashtag?
Oh my God, sorry for the egg. I don't know, man. I don't know why it echoes. And I don't know why Tidy Labs doesn't work. And I saw other people's Tidy Labs working. It's a joke, dude. I'm going to go to the site real quick and just see what in the world. Excuse me. Yeah, dude, we'll look at two S coins. I've never heard of either one. Wow. That is so rare, dude. Dude, Tidy Labs. All right. It's supposed to be like Streamlabs, Stream Elements, but for DLive, and it's terrible. Like, just doesn't work. What's up, John Legend, man? Yeah, well, don't be a TU fork on Bitcoin price actions developing two upsloping converging trend lines, which we know what that is, dude. What do we know what that is, man? Good Lord, man. All the hurdles and hula hoops involved. Okay, dude. Okay. Yes. Dude, whatever, man. So bad. Well, thanks for the lemons. Litecoin's wrestling the 100. Wob Guan Blood. That's right, Jangalese. Me too. I wholeheartedly agree. All right, BNB. Let's see, man. We hear a beep ever. We're going to be making highest highs of the impulse, the highest highs we've seen since January 2018, man. Let's be kings. Let's keep pumping, baby. Too much buying pressure, too much demand for this asset. It's how it was described yesterday after, well, a couple days ago, after creating that tweezer double bottom, definitely a double bottom with a bullish engulfing candle at a critical support that must have been held. And here we are, pivoting. All right. XHV Connect. Wow, man. Thought you misspelled Verge. Oh, God, dude. Give me this crap, man. Pumpy dumpy. Oh, my God, man. Isn't that crazy? The XABC. D. Where do we go? No, we didn't hit the 1272 before crabbing out. So, no, it didn't work. It did not work, man. Your fib extensions didn't play out. I mean, it's weird. You just kind of are crapping out randomly before the 1272, which is really weird. Okay. So, I don't even know what to tell you, dude. That's how you would be using your fib extensions, okay? Just weird. Anyway, dude. I mean, the only thing that might make sense to me is like this or something. It doesn't even really make, I mean, I guess I get the 25 respect as resistance. But dude, there's just like no structure. It's just like, what do you want from me, Eli? I thought we were friends, man. You're making lower highs than your previous highs. Oh, that's great, dude. That's great. This is just not a setup. Not really. This is not really a setup that I see. Okay. You could tell me what you think about this chart, but for me, dude, I don't even know. This is I've never even seen this before. Okay. There's not a pattern. There's not a structure. There's nothing going on. That's it on XHV. Okay. Yes, it does look like poo. Jangalese, it does. I mean, looking at the 4-hour chart, same thing. It's just, I mean, think about it like this. It's like, what's up, GDC? Thanks for the follow on Twitch. So get an impulse down, right? So from your high to low, would we get to a 50% retrace? Oh, very, very close to that 50% retrace for selling off. Upsloping consolidation after an impulse down equates to what? Well, a lot of times just bear pull, bear flag. Not really sure how to make sense of that wick, man. If we even see that, these low liquidity S coins, do they do these stupid wicks and they like screw everything up. Like, it's really tough for me to like plot something. Obviously there's an upsloping support. And if you just ignore the wick and just go with the next wick, hey, heartline respect right there. So in possible scenarios, you break to the upside, you hit the heartline again, sell off and then dump, or you break the heartline, you break to the upside and you hit the top again, you hit 12,871. But this is not some sort of a powerful stuff. I mean, it's not really that great. I get the higher lows. Yeah, you're definitely showing forms of accumulation going on, but the move happened, dude. The pumpy dump on XHV happened, and now it's sold off, and now it's upslipping with this consolidation, which is not really bullish. Okay. Broadening wedge, I mean, maybe. Okay, does that make it any better? That's still a bearish pattern. Inherently, anyway. So what, we run up to the upside and we did the top, man? 16,000? Okay, go for it. But I don't see coinciding variables that give me a reason to believe why we would do that. I mean, you realize, like, the trend we're in, right? All right, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows. That's all we are. That is us. That is XHV. It is a scrub trend, all right? Anyway. Good luck. Yeah, good luck. I don't know, man. This is terrible. This give me a headache looking at this. I'm sorry. It's not your fault. Oh my God. Just when I thought it was bad. Something I haven't seen in a billion years. Wow, dude. Really? Here we go. Brian Jones, man, hello.
Mitchell DB Cooper A. Crypto Kai of the RSI bow to your sensei. Could you look at XLM? Thank you. Hope you didn't get any of that storm.
Oh, got plenty of the storm, dude. It was so close. Let's say it was like four miles. Tornado touchdown, like 4 miles away. Which sounds like a long way away, but dude, when you see it on the radar, like I literally should have sent a picture. I was like Meadowbrook area, like that's like where I'm at, and it's like I think a tornado was like right there, dude. Okay, so I'm just lucked out. Okay, night of the tornadoes though, because it was like going on all night, like in the state of Alabama. It was just like tornado warning. Okay, two or three are going on, maybe four, and then like one expires and another one pops up. It was just like, okay, so you're like waiting for the storm to get here, and it's just like, yep, of course, crazy tornado warnings and stuff. So all right, okay, so this is DTA data connect. Okay, how do we look at it? Kind of like a range where you're at the top of the range, where you tried to break out three times and failed miserably. And so now you're like back inside the range, right? The overhead resistance, you couldn't break it. Or if you did break it, you did not sustain prices above it at all. Like not even close. So it looks like there's support here. I mean, you're somehow holding support at 32 sats. Wow. Formal structure or pattern. It to me just looks like a well, right angled and ascending broadening formation, doesn't it? It really does, man. So that's bearish, man. Bearish pattern, right? Where the pattern develops psychologically due to the buy wall, right? Someone this it's just like a descending triangle in a way, but it's just a little wackier. Descending triangle has to do with distribution with those lower highs. But this one has higher highs, but it has that exact same sell wall. And so really just it's just like institutions kind of FOMOing on the pumps a little bit more. And that's why you make the higher highs. But eventually what happens is you run up and then you just demand just completely tapers off after a little bit of the FOMO comes in. And then eventually what happens, you'll get a partial rise and then you'll plummet. And then after that, you're done and you just dump again. So to me, I mean, it's interesting that you're holding some support here, right? Love to see us stay above that. But look, man, are you really holding support, or is there support that you've already broken below? So you're just in the middle of the chop now. So we'll see how well we can hold that. If so, then yeah, you could have a nice run to the upside. But it's probably, if it doesn't hit this top area, that will be that partial rise, which is very bearish. Very bearish. Okay. Jeez, man. Data connect. Hey, great news though. Great news on you doing things. Okay, you kind of breaking the upside. I don't know what to do, man. Like these wicks and stuff. It's crazy. Matthew Williamson, welcome, dude. Welcome. Dude, you're talking about crazy, man. We want to talk about broadening stuff. Talking about broadening patterns. Look no further than where? XLM. Wow. Okay. Remember this? Huge impulse down. Then we formed the downsloping structure, right? The consolidation after the huge impulse, which was extremely improper, right? Okay, on this one, it's not the same. Okay, so so we don't have our support looking left that we found, and we were able to call that bottom just because we were so extremely oversold, and the market started turning around. So it was like two variables that got us to where we are now, where we at one time we were at 7.3 cents. We're now, we got as high as 13.7 cents or something. It's crazy. So just bouncing off that 200 moving average right now. We've done that before, but it was only at the beginning. All right, to me, this looks like we had a beautiful head and shoulders pattern. Wow, what a pretty head and shoulders. Dude, that is fantastic. Billy, let's print this out, man. Let's print it out. Make it a little bit cleaner. There it is. You know, one part of the neckline, second part of the neckline, you ran up. I mean, the high was a little bit lower than the previous high. That's fine. Still had the psychology behind it. The rally. This was your rally, right? You had a high, a higher high. You broke down, created the neckline, and then you tried to run again, and you got rejected almost immediately with the bearish engulfing candle, and that's where the dump happened. It was beautiful. Wow. Excuse me. And then you measure move pattern around the top of it. To the bottom, to the neckline from the breakouts. We measure and we moved. Beautiful. Gotta love it, man. And it showed up pretty nice on the 4 hour. I mean, I bet it looks even better on the 60 minute chart. Wow. So what are we doing after the huge impulse down? It looks like we're developing ourselves some sort of a potential rising wedge or flag, bear flag. Okay, not really sure which one it is. Kind of weird price action. All right, that doesn't look very good to me. That looks great for bearish consolidation, but for to say anything bullish about this, I'm sorry, man, that doesn't look good. It all ended with a slanted head and shoulders into a bear pull bear flag combination. And we'll see how far we retrace. I mean, we could go as high as 12.2 cents if we really wanted to. Hope for Bitcoin. You know, you got to pray for Bitcoin, but Bitcoin's selling off a little bit. It's under $5,100 right now. So, but there you go, man. Yeah, that's what it looks like to me. All right. So, zooming in, we see a couple beautiful textbook patterns. Very educational. Thank you, XLM, for praising us with some education today. And thank you, dude. It's just like so much, dude, right? You had the harmonic stuff, right? You had the broadening, ascending broadening wedge, and then at the top of the ascending broadening wedge we formed that smaller rising wedge pattern with bearish divergence. It broke out and we hit the freaking measure move, and not much lower than the measure move. We pivoted and ran again and created ourselves that pattern, that slanted head and shoulders into the bear pull bear flag, maybe rising wedge soon. I don't know. This beautiful, dude. Thank you, XLM. We freaking love you. We love you. You teach us something all the time, XLM. Okay, any questions at all on that one? Billy, satisfied?
Bueller.
Anyway, that's it, dude. All right. Hey, this Arona, thanks for the ice cream. XRP Yoda, thanks for the follow. Thanks, I'm glad you made it on DLOB. Five Star Emperor, thanks for the $2 super chat. Oh my god, man. $2 super chat, man. Screen melts alert. Thanks, dude. Gosh. Yeah, I noticed it last night. I talked to my IT guy about it. I don't know what to do, man. I'm out of carrots and sticks, man. And I think he is too. I'm texting him right now. Sure thing, Billy. Oh my god, man. Please clap, Seeger. Please clap, man. What's up, XRP Panic, dude? Kangs, man. We will be Kangs. Exolum will make us Kangs with education. All right. Okay, you wanted, yeah. Digitech Futures, Bitcoin Futures, all right? Just hear me out here. Yeah, I streamed like the, 3 hours plus last night, sure. That's what I do, man, I stream. I drink and I stream things. Get it?
Excellent breakdown of XLM. Could you please check that?
VK doing things.
Yeah, dude, we'll look at it right after this. Thanks, man, for the threes. Appreciate it. Oh my god, man. All right, let's get things lit on DLOB. Come on, DLOB. Let's get some crazy gifts going, man. Oh my god. Can we beat YouTube? Can DLOB beat YouTube, man? Well, I don't know, man. I don't think we can. Captain, I don't think we can. No good, man. No good. What's that, dude? What's that? I don't even know why this didn't save last time. That rising wedge. And then you got this, man. And now you got this, like, crazy angle of ascent that changed, right? So it's like a rising wedge within a rising wedge, dude. Come on. You gotta be kidding me. On Bitcoin futures. Digitech futures, dude. All right. Guess what happened right at 27,533? What happened? My God, like what? Like Ethereum, we sold off and it may not be over, dude. Okay. That entry got hit perfectly, like the Jesus man. 88.6% retrace and it sold off. And we're going to see how far we can fall if we want. All right. Beautiful, dude. Beautiful. I count sheeps. I do. I count candlesticks and satoshis in my sleep, man. All right. We're going to look at VeChain, dude, next, man. We're going to do it. You think House YouTube will be hard to take down, but House Harmonic and House DLive, we can combine forces. We have dragons, man. Yeah, hit the like button if you're enjoying the live stream, Kings. Sahar, yeah, there you go. Thanks for the donation. So we can look at VeChain doing things, all right? Well, VeChain was at a critical area. But guess what it did? It was at that critical area back testing the old ascending triangle, used it as support, and then popped. It's wonderful, all right? So, daily here. Okay, man, this is what I'm talking about. Oh, okay, that's why. That's why, because it wasn't visible on my 4-hour time scale. Gosh dang it. Okay, I gotta delete it on the 4-hour. Oh my god, dude. TradingView! Okay, here it is, right? You got bearish divergence on both oscillators. Yes, you have, in fact, triple MACD bearish divergence on Digitech Futures, okay? Very, very bad, boys. Very, very bad. Okay. So, if you have daily bearish divergence on both oscillators, if you have hit the 88.6% retrace from X to C, if you have bearishly engulfed and you hit the top of the rising wedge pattern for the third time, you would think the probabilities of us selling off would be extremely, extremely high. Just like this is the exact same type of critical thinking we used on Ethereum, talking about that bearish crab pattern. All right. This is the bearish bat. Okay. I think. No, it's not the bearish bat. The bearish bat's a higher low. Excuse me. A slightly higher low. Oh, God for crypto. Thanks for the lemon, dude. Can you have some Lino? Nah, dude. I don't think that's how it works. I don't think you just get Lino for just asking. But PewDiePie was giving out some, man. You should have asked him, dude. He would gladly have given you some lemons, dude. Monkey hanging? I don't know, man. I don't know. What about XLM, Filippo? Just say it. Can't you just rewind, man? I thought there's literally a video on demand. Like, you can definitely rewind anytime you want. If you're on your PC, I think. XLM gave us tremendous amounts of education setting up Bear Pull Bear Flag, looks like, right now. You're here to overthrow YouTube? You're here for the overthrow of YouTube, Coffee Crypto. Excellent, man. Excellent. Guess what? Bitcoin is bearishly engulfing on the 60-minute chart with 29 minutes left. Holy crap, dude. Oh, anyway, so let's go to VeChain doing things. All right, dude. Digitech Connect. You get it, though, right? You get it. Seal, please. Yeah, see that nice freaking bounce? Support. You hit it. You had no formal support on the way down until you got to this point and you bounced. All right. But unfortunately, daily doesn't look very good. Daily doesn't look good at all. I mean, nice bullish engulfing candle a couple of days ago. I think Thursday or Friday. That was Friday. But a nice little tweezer double bottom, kind of like BNB. But different context completely, right? In a way, in a lot of ways. But see, the spike in negative momentum is terrible. On the RSI, you're 45, so plenty of room to run to the downside if you really, truly wanted to. Ugh. Hey, man, can't get mad about it for us, dude. We, dude, 106 or 107 was our entry. Both targets hit, and this was the measure move. This was the second target of our trade setup. It was it. Now, we know, we think in time, you know, barring any acts from Bitcoin or God, we would see at least 167 to 207 because that is the common retrace area. But you can't say we didn't get somewhat kind of close to it. We were less than 10 sats away from hitting the beginning of the golden zone. The daily bearish divergence played out very well, right? We had been talking about this every time we analyzed it. Okay, you got bearish divergence and you can't break above the measure move area, which I don't even know. Like, there's no real resistance here. I think it is only, I mean, you could have done probably fib extensions. Let's see here. You might have hit like a 1618 or something. All right, from the height of the pattern to the low point. Nah, you went way beyond that, dude. See, it's nothing. There's literally nothing here, dude, that made us stall except people just taking so much profit at our measure move of a triangle.
Is that a joint?
Oi, what's up, Lord Miss Ray the TA King? At this one do big descending triangle. Broke out to 180, retested 163. You think it can pop up now? Measured move would be 230. Cheers, Lord Ray. BTW, I got a 5-week-old husky puppy. It's the cutest thing ever.
If you have a 5-week-old husky puppy, post it in community IRL in our Discord, and I can show the world your puppy. That's how it works, dude. Dude, like, this community is insanely qualitative, right? So, like, if you, like, join our community, like, we care about, like, things that go on in your life and stuff. And, like, that's why we have community IRL. And, dude, we'll go be live and someone says something and I'll post it and everyone will see it in our community while I'm live, okay? So, go ahead. If you're not in our community, in our Discord, you better join. It's just, it doesn't make sense for you to be a part of this community in the live chat, not to be a part of it in the Discord, because in the Discord, we talk about charts. We post charts all the time. You can't post charts in YouTube chat, but you sure as heck can do it in our general chat, okay, in Discord. And that's what we want. If you have questions, you want to get in contact with me or anyone else in the community, that is the best way to do it. Join our freaking Discord if you want to be Kang or Quain. All right. Ben, how? It's called the Fib Channel, and we've manipulated the Fib Channel. Okay, instead of the 618, whatever, the 382, you got 0, 0.25, 0.5, 0.75, and 1. That's it. Congratulations. You now know. All right. So I don't really know, man. I don't think we have any kind of patterns that have developed on VeChain yet. 4 hour. I mean, it looks like an impulse up, and then you're just looks like there's consolidation. We might have another run to the upside, but you're below on the four. Look, you just had a 4 hour death cross. That's not really good. April 13th. That was yesterday. We had a 4 hour death cross on VeChain. Man, I was just so excited about us potentially getting a golden cross on the daily. Hey, Krabs, man, thanks for the two diamonds, dude. We'll play Jesus Challenge for two diamonds. It's almost $3 or something, I think. There you go, dude. Thanks again, Krabs, man. Much love. Please spam community IRL, Kappa. That's it, dude. Holy crap. What does the next move look like on VeChain? Dude, hard to say, man. Like, I mean, we could attempt to plot some channel, like use anchor points. Look, you're still a way off, man. And I don't even know if this is accurate. All right, it's like you got 1 and 2 on the top and then 1 and 2 on the bottom. And so if you have an impulse up and then you consolidate like this, most of the time, I mean, that's like an impulse, and then you can consolidate after the impulse, and you're just kind of creating like a pennant of some sort, right? A little small pennant. But it's very low volume and liquidity on VeChain. Like, the candles look like there's low liquidity on them. Okay, so, dude, I don't know, man. Like, maybe we could sell off and double bottom. If we could somehow, some way, freaking double bottom off this support, wow. That I would be happy with that. I would probably do a trade setup on that if we could come back down and backtest 127. If we sold off again, what could happen is we had low on price, lower low on price. We had bullish divergence. That is what made us break to the upside. If we could somehow sell off again, by the time we get down here to backtest, we would probably have an even lower level of negative momentum, and we would have bullish divergence on the RSI, which would be amazing. A great combination for potential trade setup. Double bottom. All right, that's what we'd be looking for. But this thing could obviously run to the upside again if it wanted to, because impulse and then consolidation after the impulse, you set the tone for the consolidation, which was a bullish impulse. So you might do it again and hit the top of the channel, then sell off and make maybe an even larger potential double bottom. All right. Yeah, good, Billy. That's it. So let's go back to Ethereum for Mr. Anonymous, I think it was. Thanks, Anonymous. I know you probably didn't mean to be that, but. Okay, you're saying something about a descending triangle. Let me reread what you said. Okay. Thanks for the 26 people over on DLive. Get over there if you want to be kings. Oh my god, I saw Ali G posted something about a Peking, a Chinese duck on the rotisserie, and I'm like, oh my god, I hope he didn't post this husky. All right. Wow. Irwin Coffee, Chris Irwin said, Fortnite, well, he didn't say it, he posted an article, Fortnite World Cup Finals with $30 million at stake. Dallas, are you lying, dude? I gotta get some confirmation. Hold on. No, he did not. How could he win the Masters? It's only like, dude, it's like 3 Eastern, 3:30 Eastern. The Masters doesn't end till like 6 or something. Don't you be trying to debate me, dude. Okay. Dude, did he really win? How's it over already? I don't ever remember watching the Masters and it ending at this time, dude. Ever. Anyone? At all? Anyone? I don't know, man. Okay. That's crazy, dude. Let's get something going for Tiger then, if he won the Masters, all right? Give me a sec. We gotta make it, we gotta pay our respects, okay, to a man who once flew so high with his wax wings. He flew so high and got so close to the sun that he melted. He melted with debauchery and whatever, you know, lots of promiscuity, and fell from grace and has now ascended again, has risen from the ashes like the phoenix, and now is now king. Wow, beautiful, dude. Okay, I'm looking for something. I'm gonna post it. All right. Wow. I don't know. I mean, like, I guess I can't find a... Maybe I'll find a sticker. A sticker would be perfect, right? Dude, that is the dumbest sticker I've ever seen. Of course, there's only one freaking sticker of Tiger Woods, and it's the dumbest thing I've ever seen, man. This is the only sticker I can find. Let's create my own. Oh, this is it. It's so stupid. Wow. Okay, I'm just gonna do Masters. Okay. Dude, whatever. I guess we're just gonna skip this and say screw it. Okay. I can't find anything I'm looking for. Since a lot of people don't care about the Masters on the internet. So anyway, so you're saying descending triangle on Ethereum. And the one day big descending triangle. Broke out to 180, retest to 160 something on the daily. Descending triangle. Well, how in the world can we have a big descending? Are you talking about up here? I'm just confused. Give me some time, Elon. Okay, give me like a... What date? Broke out to 180. Dude, show me your chart in Discord and general chat, okay? Thanks, because I don't... Descending triangle. You don't accumulate in descending triangles. We are accumulating, okay? Higher lows is not... There's no way. There's no distribution going on. There's only accumulation going on right now, right? So, and to me, I'd see harmonics, right? Harmonic connect. Beautiful. Come on, dude. Let's hit our second target on the bear pull bear flag. Let's go, dude. Let's go. The Masters is over. Yeah, Raymond. It seems like it's, it is, man. It seems like it is. What's up, dude, nuh-uh. Dude, whatever. What a fake account, dude. A fake PewDiePie account just followed, dude. Thanks for the fake follow, dude. What's up, XRP Panic? Thanks for the follow. Holy crap, man. What's up, Mr. Colo? Well, it's like baseball, man. It's like these are fun sports to play. They're just not really that interesting to watch. I don't know, man. Yeah, JP has a very good point. JP says, people say golf is slow to watch as they watch a crypto chart on a four-hour time scale. Dude, the biggest touche of my life. Okay, very good, JP. Very, very good, man. All right. And it's like, dude, you could go and you could gamble on golf, and then it's almost very similar to trading, right? Because there's money involved. That's why we stare at these charts, because our money is on the table, right? So we could definitely go bet on Tiger to win the Masters, right? Biggest hindsight ever, right? Oh my God, I should have bet on Tiger to win, dude. That wouldn't have been a very good strategy for a long time. Okay. Jeez, man. Bueller? Can we get some Buellers on freaking D-Live, man? Good Lord. That is true. We fly high. We noticed that, and we also talked about White Walkers. How insane was that, dude? When we broke the ascending triangle cell wall? How insane, dude. Okay. Come on, dude. Give me I need to see these baby huskies. I need to see these descending triangles that could be on Ethereum that I'm missing here. Somebody. Help me, man. Anyway, wow. Lot and lots of action, dude. Lots of action. Okay. Feel like I'm Teddy KGB, man, right now. Good Lord. I don't know, man. It feels good, kind of like now the fact that I'm like going now, being live this early. It's been a long time, dude. It's been like, I think maybe like 10, 11 months now since I've had a stream this early during the day. I used to do streams at 2 o'clock all the time when I started streaming. It was like 2 o'clock and 10 o'clock always. And then it just I don't know what happened, but we just kept moving the time down. Ah, gotcha, John.
I moved up the tea times today to avoid the incoming storms. I can't stand Tiger, but respect his talent. Not everyone can be the best ever. I like playing golf, but can't watch it. Like watching whale dung drop to the bottom of the ocean. LOL.
John Witten, man. Thanks for the 3-3-2. Not repeating, of course, at all. Thanks, dude. Much love. Yeah, that's crazy, man. So that was it. Those storms that hit me last night hit them today. Okay. I'm surprised, though. If they, what the weather looks like for Augusta. Thanks, Filippo. Tornado watch right now for Augusta. So the storm was, it wasn't going that fast. It was going like north pretty fast, but not really east very fast. So a lot of the Gulf winds, less of the Arctic. Have we looked at Hot Sahara? No, we have not looked at Hot Connect. Hot Connect, Boring Connect. Promising, and then just decided to go sideways for a year. And it's now at, 24, we're back to the scary time. I mean, we're still developing that divergence, man, on Hot here. What's up, The One? Welcome. Are you Keanu Reeves, man? The One, dude? On D-Live, welcome. So look, dude, you're out of the channel, which sucks. That's not really good. It's not what you were looking for at all. But, you're probably going to touch that 200-day moving average soon. Feather going sideways. You've got the daily bullish divergence. It's developing and it's continuing to mature. Man, it's getting better and better and better for Hot, man. It's getting better and better right here. Okay. So, RSI, I mean, not really helping, but you're kind of diverging a little bit. That was a low. This is a lower low. Higher lows roll to strength. So, whatever, man, not too much to read into. I love how the volume is receding like insanely well. Look, we have like the lowest level of volumes like we've seen since before this pump to the upside, right? We're like matching volume right before we exploded to the upside on this first falling wedge, right? So love the receding volume, love the daily bullish divergence on Hot Connect, okay? But I just don't really like how we're taking our sweet time when we should be breaking out. My measure move's going to suffer. It's going to go a little bit lower. You are the one or one. The symbol is THX. Sweet man. Live is good. Live is well. Did you hear Tiger Woods won the Masters? Holy crap, dude. And almost got killed by a tornado last night. But other than that, man, everything's great, man. What's up, Ryan Phillips? Coming in from Mobile. Hey, me too, man. We had it bad, dude. And it, like, I mean, how do you, like, sleep through that, dude? Like, my, like, NOA is, like, going off over and over and over. MK, the stream time changes. Well, I mean, the stream time changes, really, we didn't change much. It was just the daylight savings time came into play and screwed things up. And at this point, it's just Sunday. I was going live because I know PewDiePie was live for a minute, and like there were more people on DLive, so we might have been able to, you know, if PewDiePie was live, that means like a lot more people are searching, so we might get seen by more people, might get more followers. Didn't really play out. I mean, we haven't really, nothing's happened. He went offline like as soon as I went live, so. Mr. Smith is actually the one. The Oracle had to make Neo believe he is the one to destroy him because Mr. Smith was a danger to the whole Matrix. Dang, dude, man. Yeah, it did. And it was a really weird. They didn't have the robot voice anymore. It was like a human voice, but it was definitely robotic-y. It was so, it was super dystopian and scary. Okay. Gosh, dang it. Hold on. Hold on, I'm texting. I'm doing the texting thing. SMS texting, you know? Sorry. Oh, yeah. Cool. Hey, Juba R, thanks for joining. Welcome. P3C, I'm sorry, I am faithful to P3D, the one. Sorry, dude. Kappa, oh my god, so many Kappas. All right, hot is ready to roll, dude. Okay. Anyway, that was hot. Boat Day Crypto Day, Ben Smith, what's up, dude? How's XRP looking for breaking that resistance? What are you talking about, renewable guy? That resistance? What is that resistance? Okay, so we're still just waiting for potential entry. Dude, this was nuts, dude. If you weren't watching earlier, look. It's crazy, man. My hypothetical histogram wickage being Kangs, dude. Being straight up Kangs. So anyway, that's what we're looking for. We're looking for a 786 entry at 31.4 something cents. 31.46 cents. It's the entry because down at that level, if we're able to get there again, I think after this positive histogram action, we're going to be getting the negative. And guess what happens? You're going to make a slightly lower low than your previous low, and you're going to be making lower levels, negative momentum. And that is, we're preemptively setting up for higher prices at 31.5 cents. Can we see the future, man? Will it happen? It's all about probabilities, but if all these things play out the way we want them to, it could be a wonderful trade setup, all right? It's cool, man. Well, we got TA. Well, if you got P3C coins, I got TA with Mitch Ray coins, dude. Okay. I'll put my Mitch Ray TA coins any day against P3C coins, dude. We can sync up and be like a Tamagotchi battle. All right. My Tamagotchi. Well, you know, the little, remember the battle bots or whatever they were? You could like sync them up in like grade school against your friends and you could battle your little Tamagotchi. We'll do that with your S coin and my S coin, okay? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Man, dude. I'm excited. Very, very excited. What's SMS? What's not SMS, dude? That's the main question, okay? Hey, what's up, Storm Rage? Oil guy doing crypto. Welcome. Thanks for all the people that have joined the Discord. A nice amount today. Again, hit up our Discord if you want to be Kangs. Anyway, that's it, dude. So you, whatever, go sideways, or you just dump again, and we just look for this. We enter, We can set up loose-ish stops. Okay. And then we got our targets. Our targets are looking left. 382, 618, 100% retrace. Okay. And this could usher in the beginning of the breakout that we've been so coveting on XRP for so long. The price contraction is almost but done. It's almost done, dude. And on the tail end of this pattern, this huge triangle, we're developing a very nice bullish Gartley. Potential bullish Gartley, because we're not there yet. We're close. Just not there yet. So guess what ushered in the beginning for us on Bitcoin? Oh, bullish Gartley. No, this is a bullish cipher. My God, I'm losing my mind, dude. Sorry. Bullish cipher. Bullish Gartley on Bitcoin. So this is the cipher, dude. Sorry. Hey, it happens. It's harmonics. Okay. Thanks for the 25 people on DLive, and thanks for the around 200 people on YouTube. Fantastic. Let's get a like spike going. If you're in here and you're enjoying the coverage, the early stream, whatever, just hit that like button, that bell, that sub if you want to see this channel grow, man. Thank y'all. How do you join Discord? There's a link Mr. Kanatoma posted. All right. That's right, Guy Gamer. Texting. Well, F you, man. Got to keep them. Yeah, F me, dude. It's a new meme. F this guy. I think we've had that one, though, for a while, right? That one's been around for a long time. Okay. Jeez. Let's see. I think someone requested something. Let me see here. Oh, wow. Here is the baby. The baby husky from earlier. Oops. The baby husky, dude. A cute little baby puppy husky, man. Beautiful. Treat it well and it will take care of you. It will be your dire wolf through these. For the night is dark and full of terror. Okay. Beautiful. Your chart is an ascending triangle, not a descending triangle. Gotcha, dude. Gotcha. I understand what you're saying, and other people have that belief that that could be the case. And you may not be wrong, man. You may not be wrong. But, dude, I don't know, man. Bitcoin has only made a common retrace. It could run up some more, sure. But we're looking at the butterfly in the short term. And his chart was this on Ethereum. Right. You got the accumulation and then the ascending triangle. I know Kanatoma and other patrons have had that same thought on what we're doing. It's like, were we backtesting an old resistance as support? It sure as heck looks like it to some degree. But then it's like you had one and two touch points, but then you get one and two, and then I think three, four with the wicks, you get a rising wedge, and we sold off at the top resistance. So yeah, maybe. But and really, you know, you're analysis and mine on the US dollar tether pair kind of line up, because let me show you. This is the way I look at it. This is all time highs way up here, $1,420.
Is that a joint?
We broke out, man. We fell out and here we are. I know there's not much data on this tether chart, but it's just fun to look at. Look where we are, man. Back from that wick way back August of 2017. Trying to get above that. If we break that, then we could see ourselves easily at 215.84. That is the next real resistance candle low close from September 2017. It would really be nice to see us get there. And we are very, very, very close now to getting a golden cross on the daily time scale, which is quite significant. But if you see the wicks, right, it's just like, it's like that. I get your back test, that's why you have the horizontal line there, but I got 1, 2, and 3 touch points here on mine versus you get 1 and 2, and yours is arbitrary. Yours is a wick and a candle close, or mine's wick, 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 another wick, and now we had rejection atop of it, right? And this was right at the beginning. That was like X, A, B, C, D, right? The 3, 6, 1, 8 fib extension. So there are multiple schools of thought here on what could be developing on Ethereum. Is it a rising wedge, or is it an ascending triangle that is now broken out and back testing? I think what it really is X to A to B to C, and then we look for D at 194. 194 is the entry for a short position on Ethereum. That's it for your huge potential, very well developed, almost at target bearish Carly pattern. Okay, X, A, B, C, and D. 194. Okay, that's just the way I look at it, man. And obviously I could be wrong, and I don't think you're wrong. I think your analysis is fine. I just I don't really know about where we're going. I know if we were to make a common retrace from not even all-time highs, but the only discernible daily swing high that we have, and that's get back from May 4th, May 5th. I'm talking, dude, you've been selling off for a year, okay? So much that you don't even have a daily swing high until you go back a year. That's how terrible this thing has been getting destroyed. So I understand where you and other people will be coming from to say it's an ascending triangle, because exhaustion, complete exhaustion on the selling, bullish divergence, higher lows now. You broke above the 200-day moving average, where we had not even touched the 200-day moving average since May 24th of last year. Okay, could be getting a golden cross soon. Have not even hit a 23.6% retrace, which is 260. And we know just common retrace levels from a high to low on any traditional market, the same way we do it here. 370 to 549. It's not weird. And I'm not saying a bull run has begun. Even if we ran up to these prices, that does not make us anything bullish. I'm sorry. You can make a lot of money on the way up, but to say the market is now bullish because we hit these targets does not mean anything at all. Okay, this is just common retrace stuff. It's the exact same mentality I had for months on Bitcoin when it went from the high to the low, right? From its high point to low point, November 7th to the 15th of December. She's using the exact same type of critical thinking. Okay, that's it, man. Ethereum Connect. It's a little bit of crypto thing. Thanks for joining us on D Live. Welcome. Anyway, we just on the 60-minute just bearishly engulfed. 5,089 right now. What? I thought that was supposed to be Ripple, man. Can't believe it. JLB says, I liked because you came on at your old time and I could watch, but that's the only reason. Thanks, dude. Wasn't my charting, right? Chris Ferris, that's literally the thing we've been talking about, dude. Our friend posted his chart and gave his argument for the ascending triangle, which I don't literally, I'm playing devil's advocate because everything's up for interpretation, isn't it? Yeah, dude. There you go, Walter. Being there. It gets posted, I think, when I remember all the HBO and HBO Go and stuff. It's like at 10 Eastern or whenever, 9 Eastern, whenever it plays, like a minute after it's like playing, it will then become available on HBO Go for you to watch, okay? Crypto thing, you're new to D-Live, just seeing what's up. I don't know, it's kind of dead today, man. It's like, yeah. Like, I don't know, the first couple of days we were on it, it was awesome. Now it's just kind of like, you know, we're not getting like many new people are like coming into our chat and seeing it, right? And like subbing or following, right? It's just I think we had like 7 new subs or 7 new follows today since I started, but I've been live for like an hour and 15 minutes, hour 16 minutes now. So, I mean, I don't know, man. I really don't know what's going to happen with DLive, especially DLive and crypto. Okay, I don't even know. Crypto Dactyl, thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it, dude. Okay. Okay. So here we are, man. Here we are. Something I like. I like it a lot. Did a video on it yesterday. A freaking video, man. Well, well, well. crazy. Triple MACD. Bullish divergence. Guess what, dude? Entry. Okay. Entry on the trade setup. So now we wait. Bullish cipher with the divergence on both oscillators. You got to be kidding me, dude. You've got to be freaking kidding me. So this has all the makings of a varsity athlete. Not only do you have the triple MACD bullish divergence, the RSI bullish divergence, the bullish cipher pattern hitting 78.6% retrace, you're also still within the parameters of a beautiful, beautiful uptrend that's extended on all the way back when it started December 12th. All right. Super Kangage, man. Super duper Kangage. Ascending triangle measure move Kangs. Run on up, dump, then pump, then dump again. And here we are at entry for the bullish cipher pattern. Wow.
I've seen all of the new Game of Thrones episode. Would you like me to ruin the ending for you?
Nah, dude. I would not appreciate that. Thanks for the sailboats, dude. You must have some serious connections. Okay. Kangs. Sweet Christopher, man. Sweet. It's pulling a Joe Dirt. Don't try to church it up. Corey, good morning from New Zealand. Good afternoon from the States. Welcome. Dude, who cares about DNT coin? Yeah, it's up 23%. Who cares? Like, it already happened. It's not cool anymore. That's not, we don't look for things that are up 23%. We don't care, right? It just doesn't matter. You know what we look for? We look for things that are about to do those things. And this is something that looks poised to do that. All right, just saying. But whatever, man. We can look at like really, we can waste our time looking at stupid S coins with low liquidity that pump and dump. Sure. Sure we can. Or we can look at things that are setting up for higher prices potentially soon. But what would you rather look at, chat? I'd rather look at things like this. Okay. Most people are here for games. Yeah, I know. It's story of my life, man. Story of my life. Crypto and gaming kind of go together. Yeah, because when people finally like realize, hey man, gaming is a waste of time for the most part, unless you do it for a living. But then eventually, I think one would probably grow out of that, as we've seen with the first gen YouTubers that did stream, that now stream still for a living, like Wings of Redemption. I mean, think about it. Most people stream, they get success when they're young, which I think is terrible. You have success when you're young in streaming, you don't develop any real world skills. So what happens when you get older? What happens when 10 years go by and you've been doing it for 10 years? That's all you've been doing, is just playing games for a living, right? Hey, maybe you saved up money, but chances are, since you didn't develop any real world skills, you may not have managed your money well enough and maybe blew it all, spent it, you know, because you pay a lot in taxes and stuff. So ends up being, you know, you have to have fiscal responsibility. So by the time they get to 30 and up, where I'm at, I'm at 30, 31, they realize, dang, dude, I don't really want to play video games the rest of my life, dude. Crap, I'm stuck. because I don't have anything else. Some don't go to college or drop out of college, or maybe they have a degree, but they have literally no experience in the real world. So they have no fallback. Dude, if this closed up shop and just all of a sudden randomly, I can't stream tomorrow, I'd be fine. I'd be like completely fine, right? Because I have real world skills. But again, these young people are going to find out it's a false prophet. The right way to do streaming, I think. And of course, there are others like Ninja, the big ones, PewDiePie, all of them. Of course, man, it doesn't really apply to them. It applies to most people that are just like, okay, average everyday streamers. They're going to find out how important their 20s were and how much they should have invested in themselves, but they really weren't investing in themselves at all. They were just streaming because the money was coming in. Okay. Anyway. Bye, hi, see you, hello, all in. McDonald's drive through. Miss Kentama, man. I'm again, dude. Dang, dude. Y'all don't even want to talk. Y'all just want S coins. We already looked at that. Huh. You used to trade crypto until you took a leverage short to the knee. You took a bearish engulfing candle on leverage to the knee. Just Drew. Okay. Jangleese, exactly. I don't care about things that are up 20% today. Unless we were discussing what could potentially happen and then they play out. Those are good. So Barry FW, welcome. Yeah, Mitch Jones, dude. Yeah, and the fact, I think the guy like burnt every bridge with every other like larger streamer, dude. Okay, he was like drama queen, like a hardcore one. So, yeah, dude. How's that World of Warcraft plan going for you? I think he doesn't even do it anymore. Okay. What was it we were going to look at? How did this one manage when it hit that crazy downswing resistance? Dude, it's so amazing. Dude, I freaking love ETC to USDT because of how much it respected the TA. Like, oh my God, dude. Look at this on the daily. All right, so, I mean, I know there's more data, sure, but we're just looking at a chart. This is the only data we have, okay? So, on ETC, we formed that symmetrical triangle. We broke out, hit the measure move, and went a little bit higher and closed in reverse tweezer double topped right at the down sloping resistance. No higher. No higher. We have since sold off. Wow, dude. We hit the top of the golden zone. We hit the golden pocket. Okay. And we have since sold off. So we're above the 200 moving average still. That's great. You're not really, I don't know what you're holding as support. Like the support is down at $5.67 and you're holding a little bit above that at $5.85. So bouncing. No, sure, man. Prevailing trend is bearish. We'll see what happens, man. It'd be momentous to break out of this for real. Okay. Very high. Your RSI was very high is what I meant. Like 88 on the RSI. It's crazy. 360 no scoop, bullish divergence, man. We did it, man. Holy crap. Dude, and it's like a request show, but we've been live for like an hour and 30 minutes, and I don't know, man. Just remember, like, if you're just spamming chart requests, you're just spamming tickers, it's not really like.
Is that a joint?
I don't know. I mean, everyone does that.
The new pump signal is a 1941 Gartley. Pamp it, mine.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. It's 420, dude. Pamp it. Connect. Mon. Juan. Kings, dude. Let's give it that 4. Freaking 20. 3 more likes for fireworks. See, there we go, dude. People are like spamming requests probably before they even hit the like button. All right. Anyway. So, man, we just looked at Litecoin, by the way, dude. Wow, that's actually a thing. Dude, I can't believe we're actually seeing so many coins I've never seen before. Oh, I'm gonna vomit, dude. Yeah, dude, I'm gonna vomit, man. Someone literally wants me to analyze this. Pinto coin. Pinto bean coin. I don't know. They're both terrible. Hitbit. Here you go, dude. Someone's like, can you analyze what it is?
Price gonna dip.
Oh, yeah. Crazy. Oh, we got fireworks. Dang, dude. It's like my... I keep saying I'm down, but I'm not down. In the world. Restream's like crapping out. So, 7,000 sats. Whoa, dude. Whoa. We're gapping down in crypto. We're doing it, man. We're literally doing what no one's ever done before. We're just gapping down in crypto in a 24/7 market. Wow. You want to see it, man? You really want to see the charting? Here we go. Here we go. There it is. Downsloping structure. That's it. 200-day moving average finally catching up. Last time you never... Never mind. Never mind, dude. Good luck. Good luck to you on Pinto Connect. All right. Beautiful. It's probably my side, Kanatomo. It was definitely my internet connection was screwing up. It was saying it or something. Okay. Yeah, it was. I think it's connection. I don't know why. Dude, it's so stupid. I'm going to turn down my... it's weird. I have my... I've got my bitrate at 6,000, but for some reason, it goes above that, and it's like 6,400 bitrate, which I don't know why. Okay. I'm going to turn down the bitrate for the next stream or whatever. Okay. So there's your Pinto Bean Connect. Oh, I forgot. IOTEX. Okay, dude. Yeah, I forgot it. Thanks for... You're welcome. You're welcome, dude. Let's go to Bitcoin. Jeez, man. I love the gratitude. Okay, man. So what we're looking at right now... What we're looking at is a rising wedge. Yeah, a rising wedge on Bitcoin. Okay. You see it? I'm going to get rid of that teal trend line in a second. But, okay, impulse down, rising wedge. And so we could get as high if we wanted to jump to the top of the pattern again. We go to 5184, all right? 5200 if we're lucky. Good. But for now, it's just 1 and 2 on the bottom and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 on the top. Wow. Could be setting up for lower prices, but slight, not much lower. Okay, so we take this back, right? Measure move of the flag or of the right here. I feel like, look, man, though it could go down here. Remember, you like going with like the most recent pattern that develops, right? So if that's the case, we're talking like this. So measure moves nothing. Not bad at all. So wherever we broke out, that's exactly what we'll be looking for. We would want something just like this because that would be exactly what would give us our bullish divergence. Let's just move this out a little bit. There you go. See the...
Have you looked at forever Chinese XRP/BTC on the daily? And sorry, I can't reveal my connections.
I mean, I looked at it. It was like failed. Yeah, it failed, man. It just... Yeah, I can keep selling off. It's near the bottom of the channel. Crazy enough. All right. Thanks, dude. All right. So rising wedge, measure move. We broke out. Be around 49.10 or something. Okay, roughly. Where you're right now, no man's land. No man's land. There's nothing here looking left. There's a little bit here from October of 2018. That's it. That's all you're holding. So, you know, below the 886, man, you're at a 95% retrace at this point. I'm sorry. That's terrible. Let me go ahead and say screw it. Let's go to the 4-hour real quick. So I can make this visible on the daily. so you can see it. And that divergence, all none of it played out. It happens, man. It's a game of probabilities. It is not and never has been a game of certainty. All right, never. You get one wrong, you get four others right. Wow, good figure. Okay, so let's go to daily. There it is. Very, very nice downsloping structure towards the bottom of it again, right? But you got some support here looking left. Divergence, that's a lot of negative momentum, man. So you might have a little bit of bullish divergence, maybe. Nice receding volume. You're oversold again. And yeah, but we don't know where the bottom is. We don't know where the swing low is. So we don't even really know. This could keep selling off and keep going down to lower lows, or, you know, lower levels of relative strength, man. But eventually, yeah, you'll be getting yourself some nice bullish divergence and extremely oversold territory. Maybe it has support as where we could bounce. But dude, it's just really bad, man. Really bad. Weak support. It's very, very disappointing. Gotta be real about that. Yeah. Okay. Forever Chinese, dude. Okay, D-Live's officially dead. Alright. See y'all later on D-Live. Wow. Bye. Good God. So the rising wedge played out. The measure move, close to the measure move. Remember this? Does anyone remember this? So you have to get rid of stuff because he just gets really busy. So Crypto Marklar. Measure move from the breakout. Wow. We are just sats away. 6209 is the measure move of the rising wedge pattern. There you go, man. You're pretty much fulfilling the destiny of the rising wedge. That's it. That's what's happening. Okay. Wow. Kevin, man, actually showed people how to do it earlier in the stream. Okay. Thanks for the 200 plus people on YouTube. And thanks for the 25 people on DLab. Thanks. I don't know, man. We've been looking at things all stream. That's right. XRP Connect. Exactly, dude. You read my mind, Full Metal Music. Zcash, man, I don't know, man. Is that an inverse head and shoulders? It looks kind of like it. It's really oblong, though. Really, really oblong. I see the psychology of it, but I think you went like way too low on it for it to really be that. It's a lot of chop, though, man. It seems like a low risk area, doesn't it? I'm just talking about this, man. Zcash or whatever. Get wrecked, Groot. Get wrecked. So he's like, is that an inverse head, shoulder, left shoulder, head, right shoulder? But again, look how much lower you went, so any kind of entry was killed, like, for people. And then you got like kind of the neckline up here, meh. All right, so if you were to play it, your first target's gonna be up here if it was to play out, but I just don't think it's gonna I don't know. I don't know if the market will interpret this as an inverse head and shoulders. Psychology is there where you have accumulation, right? And people could definitely argue and say something like this now, right? Whatever the wick or the candle close, whatever, you can have them both plotted. And yeah, like I don't know if we'd use that, but you can clearly, you clearly know there's some sort of sell wall going on, right? So maybe a big A ascending triangle of some sort, right? I mean, that could be going on too. So things to think about. And really, if it crapped out, man, like you're talking like this. So there's a really, really wide range here. Really, really wide. Dang, man. That's crazy. All right, so a lot of room to run to do things, right, on Zcash. So maybe left shoulder, head, right shoulder, and if that's the case, then you got a long way to go, dude. Long way to go. All right, lowest risk going to be like 12,951. It seems like if you were to hit this one more time, right? What's up, Captain Happy, dude? Welcome. Oh, thanks for the ice cream, Drew, man. Will BNB ever retrace? Well, it kind of did a little bit, but not much. We should look to BNB like really, really early. BNB back tested the old resistance from mid-June of 2018, that 100% retrace, and then tweezer double bottomed and bullishly engulfed off of that support. Okay. So yeah, BNB, will it ever retrace? Maybe after $21. It's funny. Anyway, doesn't matter. Okay, y'all. Hour and 40 minutes, not bad, right? Yeah, I'm out of here too, Canatomo. I'm out of here too. Kills for a living, thanks, man. Greg Morgan. Kills for a living again. John Wheaton or Wetton, sorry. Elon Musk, Anonymous. Five-star Emperor. What's up, Full Melt Music? I was calling you Full Metal Music, my bad, dude. Welcome. And thanks, Brian Jones. Eli Bach, CoinLinked, and Edward DeSantos. Thank y'all for the contributions today, Super Chat, tips, whatever. Oh my God, we've done it, man. The most legendary number of all time. 5959. Yes! Love it, baby. Probes would be so proud. Well, we just had 5958, but whatever, man. Okay. Oh, it's happening. Mike's all screwed up. Okay, sweet, man. So I'll be back tonight or something. I don't even know when I'll be back. No idea. We got Game of Thrones coming on tonight, so. Okay. I will be back. So until next time. Respect the T. A.
Adios, turd nuggets.